Welcome back to AEC BIM Talk.
If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, add a comment, and smash the like button to support this channel. Thanks.
In this fun video, we will download West Point Bridge software, use it to design a couple of different types of steel bridges, and then simulate a truckload driving over it and make adjustments to fix it. So this is really a fun video. It's pretty easy to download this free software, as you can see from the bridgedesigner.org website. And installation doesn't take very long. It's a simple click on it and it will be installed. And then once it's installed, it kind of walks you through the different steps of using the tutorials or starting with a sample bridge or starting with a new bridge. This design software for bridges was created by, I believe, the Marine Corps in the United States, and it was made available a long time ago, decades ago, for students of engineering as well as for students in college and in high school even. And I've been showing it to my students for a long time. So I thought it would be nice to share that with you. So here's the YouTube video that shows the, I'm showing you some highlights of what you would be doing in the software, designing its members and then, you know, running a truck over the bridge. So let's get started. So once it's designed, once it's installed, I will go ahead and launch it. And then simply we can go through a different design tips and read those if you want to, but you don't really have to. You can just skip that and close this and go straight to the actual content. The user interface is a pretty simple. It's been around for a long time, but this is a newer version of it. Was released in 2016. And here I'm loading a sample bridge, whether it's a flat truss or a cable truss or a suspension truss or a Pratt deck truss, sort of different types of trusses, as you can see. I'll start with a simple truss bridge that will allow us to look at the basic functionality of how this works. So this is the Warren truss bridge, and it's basically just a triangulation. As you can see, you can click on the simulate button on the top of the menu and it will show you a truck going through over the bridge. This is a sample bridge, so it is designed to withstand a truck. Now the bridge can fail based on its own weight, or it can fail based on the bad design. What I'm going to do is I'm going to try to go through the design project setup wizard and kind of show you what are some of the recommendations for design requirements and design tips you'll have there. You can make some choices as far as the local code, the deck elevation, the piers, anchorage, high strength concrete, medium strength concrete, loading, design loads, it's not made for this high end engineering design. It's more for someone who is a beginner, but it is pretty powerful because it gives you accurate information as far as the material type and cross section and size and length and slenderness and compression and tension, all that stuff, right? So in this example, I'm starting with a Warren truss template. I'm adding nodes, and then I'm going to go back and add some members, right? As you can see here, and you can right click on them, each member, and you can resize it or you can change the type of the member itself. And as you're doing that, on the right hand side you see it kind of lists all the members with their cross section and their length and their slenderness. Now, this is a simple bridge. It's no big deal. But, you know, if you make a mistake and, you know, try to simulate a bridge that does not have a triangulation, of course, it doesn't work. It's going to give you an error message. So over here in the middle, you see that where the bridge does not have a triangulation. It will tell you that the structural model is unstable. It will show you, it will highlight the area where the problem is. It's in blue, and you wouldn't have to triangulate that, right? So let's simulate that and see what happens. Here's a truck coming over the bridge, and it looks like it's going to work. Okay, so the idea here is that you want to make this bridge as lean as possible with you know, to meet code requirements, but also to you know, to be as economical as possible. You can right click on each member and you can change the cross section, as well as decrease member size or increase member size, as well as delete the member. So it's a pretty easy user interface, and anybody can use this, even for someone like me who's an architect. I'm not an engineer, but you know, it is simple enough to understand, you know, knowing the basic structural design parameters. You can see here where the bridge has failed. So, you know, it's kind of fun to see where it fails, and it highlights those members in red color. So you can go back and you can increase the size of the member or add more members. Here I'm bringing in a cable state bridge, and we're going to do the similar situation. We're going to simulate that. Nice view from the bottom to the top. You can see the middle part of the bridge is pretty bad in terms of how it deflects. Of course, this is an exaggeration of the actual behavior of the bridge. So if you were to decrease the size of those vertical members, for example, that may result in a failure. Let's see what happens when you do that. So I'm intentionally trying to make it fail so you can see it. So each of those trusses, bridges is going to fail in a different way. So you can see already that, here we go. Oh, it passed inspection. Okay, that's very unusual. Okay, so on the next run, I will make it fail. Okay, so decreasing the member size at some point will result in an economical bridge, but it will cause an issue. You can see here that the bridge has failed due to its own weight. It's not, the truck has not got on the bridge yet, right? On the next try, the truck will cause the bridge to fail just as it gets on it. Okay, let's go to a third type of bridge, which is the combined truss bridge. It has a middle pier in the middle. I'm going to raise the end supports, make them more vertical and more higher, if you will. The bridge is not symmetrical right now. You can see here where it fails. It has to do with the span, and has to do with the member sizes. So when you can adjust and fix it. So you know, this is a pretty fun thing to do, and you can learn so much about structural design and the bridge design from using this. And you can even, you know, provide that to your friends and family to use as a game, almost, you know. But it's scientific enough to give you a robust interface, as well as it's interactive UI that makes it fun to use. Here I'm adding some additional cable supports. It looks like it's working. So there's nothing more exciting than seeing things in the way it simulates the real world issues. Thank you for watching.
If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, add a comment, and smash the like button to support this channel. Thanks.